Hello, this is Colin Goble. The purpose of this example in C++ is to show you a very simple loop which keeps prompting the user to enter a password, say to enter a website or an application, and the user has to keep trying until they eventually get the password correct. I'm demonstrating this as an example of a sentinel-controlled loop, because of course you don't know how many times the loop is going to execute. It's not a counter-controlled loop. It depends on how long it takes the user to get the password correct. Okay, let's show you this program in action. Let's run the program. We'll ask the user to enter the secret password. Okay, he gets it wrong once, gets it wrong twice, three times. Eventually he remembers that the secret password is the word secret. We hit the enter key and the program determines that's correct and terminates. Okay, so we've hard-coded the password here to the word secret. Obviously that's not how a real password application would work. We ask the user to enter the password. We read the whole line that the user enters. We're not reading this a token at a time, although we could have. We're going to read the whole line from the input stream CN into the string variable line. And we're going to ask the question, is the line that the user entered equal to the string stored in password, the string secret? If it's not equal to password, to secret, then obviously the user got the password wrong. We display an error message. We ask the user to try again, and once again we read the user's reply. So the effect of this is we go round and round and round this loop until eventually line becomes equal to password. Line not equal to password is therefore false. The while loop terminates and we inform the user that their password that they entered was correct. Okay, now obviously this program has some pretty severe limitations, and there are two. The first is that if the user simply forgets their password, they have no way to just quit the program, because this program keeps prompting them for the password. And the second is they can keep trying new passwords. There's no counter on the program to make sure they don't try more than, say, three times. So this next demonstration, password 2, is essentially the same program. We're still looking for the password secret. But in this case, we're going to count the number of failures that the user has. And if the number of failures equals 3 on the third failed attempt, we're going to terminate the program and tell the user they exceeded the maximum number of attempts to get the password correct. We're also going to let the user enter the character Q to indicate that they've forgotten the password and they don't want to guess anymore. Okay, let's compile and execute this program and demonstrate what I mean by that. So the user makes a guess or enters the password, it's not correct. They enter it again, it's not correct. They enter it the third time, it's not correct. In this case, we tell them that they've exceeded 3 attempts and we terminate the program. The other possibility, of course, when we run this application is that the user enters the password, say they get it correct on the third attempt. Well, in that case, we note that they got the password correct. And finally, they may decide that they don't want to enter the password anymore, so we'll ask them to please enter the secret password. This time, well, they'll just enter Q because they don't know what the password is, and so we'll just terminate the application. Okay, let's take a look at how this works then. As before, we're going to ask the user to enter the secret password, but this time we're going to continue the loop to prompt again only if the line they entered was not equal to the password, and, note that double ampersand means and the line they entered was not equal to Q, and the number of failures is less than 3. Or in other words, if any of these 3 conditions turns out to be false, we're going to terminate the loop. We're going to terminate the loop if they entered the correct password, or if the line they entered was equal to Q, or if the number of failures was equal to 3. That's a tricky while statement there, but that's the attempt of it. We want to terminate the loop if the line's equal to the password, that means the user got it correct, or if the line is equal to Q, that means the user wants to quit, or if the number of failures has reached 3. Now, if none of those are true, we're going to increment the failure count by 1, and as before, we're going to ask the user to retry again with a new password. Now, the difference this time is when the loop ends, we reach this line of code, we reach this piece of the program right here, and we reach the closing curly brace of the while statement. And the question that we must now ask is, why did the loop end? Well, the first reason that the loop ended was the line that the user entered was in fact equal to the correct password. In that case, we'll output the message correct. The second possibility is the line the user entered was equal to Q. In that case, we're going to terminate the program. And if the loop ended and the password wasn't equal to secret and the password wasn't equal to Q, the user didn't enter Q, it must have been the case that the loop terminated because the user exceeded 3 attempts. So in that case, we'll display a message to that effect. Okay, this is a more complicated example, and you may need to think about it a while, but it's essentially a combination of a sentinel-controlled loop and involving a counter, and there's some counter control there as well. Thank you very much.